Hey, my name is Kelly with Hivehouse Digital. Today, we're going to go over the pop-up form within HubSpot. We're going to walk you through how to create it and where you can put it and some other nifty features that HubSpot puts in there. First, you're going to go to Marketing, Lead Capture, Forms. You'll click on the Create Form button right here. Now, you can see there are different options for forms. Embedded form that may be on your blog post page, inviting users to subscribe to the blog. Standalone page is typically an inbound generation campaign where you have something for them to download and you're directing traffic there. Pop-up box, that's what we're going to talk about today. You also have drop-down banner, and then you can have a box slide in from the left or the right. All right, so the function of these forms work exactly the same. They just all look a bit different. We're going to click on pop-up box. All right, let's give it a name. Highly recommend that your team sticks to a regular naming convention, labeling it as, we do it as tofu or top of funnel, mofu, middle of funnel, or bofu, bottom of funnel. This way, you are able to sort through the results at the end of the week, month, quarter, or other date range, so you can see where you may need to work on nurturing a prospect through the funnel. So let's go ahead and say we're going to name it this. All right. First off, you need to know why you're creating a pop-up form and the goal that you're wanting to hit, as that will guide the decisions you make as you create the form. In our case, let's just say that we're creating this pop-up form for someone to download an ebook that we're offering. In that case, we'll want to have an image of the ebook. We already have it uploaded to our files. Here we go. Now you'll see that right there. We're going to pretend that we're uploading our branding checklist. Next, you have the call-out text. We're going to say, download our free branding checklist. Next, the body here, you can see it's uploaded right here on the preview. Next, the body over here will offer more information about what the prospect is receiving. Think, what benefit does this offer the prospect? Look at it from their perspective. So let's type, extend your brand reach. Today by running through our free checklist. There we go. All right, you can also change the text on the button since we're going to be offering a ebook. Let's change that to download now. Gonna change it right here. Next, we'll change the color to our branded color. We already have it set up as one of our favorites. So there we go. All right, that is set up. Now you have different options for what the button itself can do. You can do form step, which means that once they click that, this button, I mean, they'll be taken to a form within the pop-up, or you can add in a non-HubSpot URL. This could be a different web page, or maybe you want to take them to a YouTube video or something. You can also go to a HubSpot page, like a landing page where you're offering something, or maybe a blog post if you host your blog through HubSpot. Also add in a file download, which would work for this example that we're doing, or a meeting link. And if you haven't seen our other video where I walk you through the steps to do that by connecting your calendar to HubSpot and set up the meetings tool, go check that out. The most common option would be the form step. Now that we have that set up, let's click on form. You have an option for description, which you'd most likely just say, fill out the form below to download this free checklist. For the form fields, you have an option for four properties, and the email is an automatic property and you can't remove it, so you really only have three. Ideally, you really want this form to have as little information as possible, so there's a higher likelihood that the prospect will fill this out. So let's just say that we also want their full name. So let's do first name and last name and then company name. And then you can just shift this around by dragging and dropping. And it's already updated over here on the side, as you can see. You also have to set the lifecycle stage. So we're going to say that that's a lead. We're going to change this form button text to say download now. And you'll set up the GDPR requirements as well. You have the option as well to put on the CAPTCHA. Highly recommend doing that so you don't get spam. All right, so they filled out their information. Now, what do you want to happen after they fill that out? Since we're offering a download, we're going to click here, add a button, click below to download. We're going to change that button to say download now. File download. We already have it uploaded. Here we go. So we're going to add that. All right. So now when someone sees this call out, download our free branding checklist, they're going to click on the download now. Then they'll be taken to this form right here. And then afterwards, they'll see this. Thank you for your submission. Click below to download. They'll click this button and then they will get the PDF right there. All right, let's look into some more options. You have the ability to be a little bit more targeted. You could have this show up on all of your pages, or let's say that you don't want them to get this pop-up when they're looking at your pricing page. You would click on exclusion rule and then add in your URL right there. You also have it pop up when they're showing exit intent. So that means they're going over to exit out of the tab or the browser. Maybe they're halfway down the page. That's when you want it to pop up. Or let's say it's been 10 seconds. You want that to pop up. Let's remove this exclusion rule. You can also set it for a period of time. Let's say that you're using this pop-up to showcase a webinar that you're doing. You can schedule it here. You can have a start date and an end date and a time. You also have the option to turn this off for mobile. I would highly recommend checking this so that users have a better experience via mobile. Also, if someone just came to your site, let's say a day ago, you want to make sure that this doesn't pop up and bug them again. So let's set this for 2 weeks. You also have the option to send an email afterwards. Let's say that you sent over the branding checklist. Now you want to send over another piece of material. This is where you would create this workflow. And then you would send up a follow-up submission. Just maybe giving a little bit more information about the company. All right, you have the final option to preview the form. There you go. You can see it for different sizes as well. And because we turned off the feature for mobile, this is turned off. From there, you can set your form to live. And hope this helped you out today. Stay tuned for more tips.